You know, once I was assigned by a professor to write a paper on why hedonistic nihilism was the only truly spiritual worldview. Hedonistic nihilism is, of course, just pleasure yourself because everything's meaningless. We're all gonna die, eat, drink, and be merry, or rape and pillage and murder, whatever you need to do. She was explaining that, you know, this was really important and we should always question authority and just do what you feel, and that's what this philosophy is. And write 3 pages on why that's the only truly spiritual worldview for 10% of your grade. But I went home and I wrote my paper. And my paper consisted of, you know, I used to be a Christian. I used to think I understood the quest I was on, the purpose of life. But then I encountered this worldview. I encountered this philosophy. And now I'm not. Now I realize I should just question authority and do whatever I feel. And I don't feel like writing this paper. And it was 3 pages, so I had this much text, and I stapled 2 blank pages to the back of it. And I went to class, and then we had to peer review it. So it passes around the class, and we're all reading each other's papers, and everybody reads mine and looks at me horrified. And wonders, are you really going to do this? And yes, I'm going to do this. And they were all writing about how hedonistic nihilism was important. I was actually pretending to live it. Shockingly, I was dragged out of a college classroom and lectured in front of everybody else and was told that I would fail the entire course. That worldview is absolute, utter nonsense. Complete nonsense. Don't tell me to question authority and then get upset when I question your authority. Don't tell me to do whatever I feel and get upset when I do whatever I feel, which is not what you told me to do. I've enjoyed philosophy always the way I enjoy a street fight or a boxing ring. It's fun as long as you end up with a bloody nose, as long as you actually end up in true conflict and you don't end up sitting there thinking, that's a really interesting thought. It's like, no, don't ponder, that's crap. Throw it away. You know, sort this. Philosophy departments are full of people wondering what it was the philosopher said. So instead of actually wondering what the world is, they look at Descartes, they look at Kant, they look at Hume, and what is it that he meant? In the whole philosopher's setup, we have Plato, who hated the material world. He imagined these perfect forms in the sky. They were wonderful. That part of the world was perfect. Matter corrupted it. And that still honestly influences a lot of Christians today, unfortunately.
Aristotle obviously just ripped off his story, then shoved the ethereal forms into the gravel and the sheet metal.
And of course, Wittgenstein was a beery swine, so we can ignore him. And Heidegger was a Nazi, so we can ignore him. And Descartes was just the little engine that could, trying to will himself into existence. You know, just, I think I am. Here we go up over the hill, the little blue train. And honestly, this is the thing that can annoy a lot of my friends. Those guys can be ignored. We don't need them. I have no problem just sort of reading them once and brushing them to the side. I think we can learn more from an anthill than we can learn from Heidegger. In the Christian world, philosophy is theology. We are the one story, the one creation myth, in scare quotes, that involves nothing. There was no God that was carved up and diced into pieces. There was no goop of chaos that was molded. There was an infinite creator, and he spoke, and his words became flesh. We walk around because we are spoken. We live because we are spoken. We can spray paint things because we are spoken. We have actual reality. That's our philosophy. We are speech. We are God's speech. God said, let there be light, and there was light. This is poetry. And when you push that into the corners and you understand the principle, the philosophy, and then you apply it to your lives, you look out your window at the blizzard, every one of these flakes is designed and spoken by a poet. And you go out there and you shovel it, you salt it, you watch the dog pee in it. And this is a poet who works on galaxies and on ants. This is a god who tells stories of world wars and this little struggle between the ladybug and the aphid on the maple leaf. You want to avoid seeing ants? You want to avoid seeing huge storms and galaxies? Well, sit in a room and talk about Kant and try to decide if ethics are logically necessary. Ultimately, Christians should have a philosophy of artists and art appreciators. That's our philosophy. And it's a philosophy that we can continue to apply through the end and never exhaust it. Because the art is never exhausted. Because the artist is never exhausted.